This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Track and field is a sport which includes athletic contests established on the skills of running, jumping, and throwing. The name is derived from the sport's typical venue, a stadium with an oval running track enclosing a grass field where the throwing and jumping events take place. Track and field is categorized under the umbrella sport of athletics, which also includes road running, cross-country running, and race walking. The foot racing events, which include sprints, middle and long distance events, race walking and hurdling, are won by the athlete with the fastest time. The jumping and throwing events are won by the athlete who achieves the greatest distance or height. Regular jumping events include long jump, triple jump, high jump and pole vault, while the most common throwing events are shot put, javelin, discus and hammer. There are also combined events or multi-events, such as the pentathlon consisting of 5 events, heptathlon consisting of 7 events, and decathlon consisting of 10 events. In these, athletes participate in a combination of track and field events. Most track and field events are individual sports with a single victor. The most prominent team events are relay races, which typically feature teams of 4. Events are almost exclusively divided by gender. Although both the men's and women's competitions are usually held at the same venue, it is one of the oldest sports in ancient times. It was an event held in conjunction with festivals and sports meets such as the ancient Olympic Games in Greece in modern times. The two most prestigious international track and field competitions are athletics competition at the Olympic Games and the IAAF World Championships in Athletics. The International Association of Athletics Federations is the international governing body. Records are kept of the best performances in specific events, at world and national levels, right down to a personal level. However, if athletes are deemed to have violated the event's rules or regulations, they are disqualified from the competition and their marks are erased. In North America, the term track and field may be used to refer to other athletics events, such as the marathon, rather than strictly track-based events. Contents 1. History 2. Events 21. Running 211. Sprints 212. Middle distance 213. Long distance 214. Relay races 215. Hurdling 22. Jumping 221. Long jump 222. Triple jump 223. High jump 224. Pole vault 23. Throwing 231. Shot put 232. Discus throw 233. Javelin throw 234. Hammer throw 24. Combined events 3. Stadium 31. Outdoor 32. Indoor 4. Rules 41. Track rules 411. Starting 412. Running the race 413. The finish 42. Field rules 5. Equipment 6. Organizations 7. Competitions 71. Olympics, Paralympics and World Championships 72. Other Championships 73. Multi-sport events 74. Meetings 8. Records 9. Doping 10. Related sports 11. See also 12. References 13. External links. History. See also History of Athletics and History of Sport. A Greek vase from 500 are among the oldest of all sporting competitions, as running, jumping and throwing are natural and universal forms of human physical expression. The first recorded examples of organized track and field events at a sports festival are the ancient Olympic Games at the first games in 776 BC in Olympia, Greece. Only one event was contested, the Stadion Footrace. The scope of the games expanded in later years to include further running competitions, but the introduction of the ancient Olympic pentathlon marked a step towards track and field as it is recognized today. It comprised a 5-event competition of the long jump, javelin throw, discus throw, stadion footrace, and wrestling. Track and field events were also present at the Panhellenic Games in Greece around this period, and they spread to Rome in Italy around 200 BC after the period of classical antiquity in which the sport was largely Greco-Roman influenced. New track and field events began developing in parts of northern Europe in the Middle Ages. The stone put and weight throw competitions popular among Celtic societies in Ireland and Scotland were precursors to the modern shot put and hammer throw events. One of the last track and field events to develop was the pole vault, which stemmed from competitions such as the Firlipin contests in the northern European lowlands in the 18th century. An early model of hurdling at the Detroit Athletic Club in 1888. Discrete modern track and field competitions, separate from general sporting festivals, were First recorded in the 19th century, these were typically organized by educational institutions, military organizations, and sports clubs as competitions between rival establishments. Competitions in the English public schools were conceived as human equivalents of horse racing, fox hunting, and hare coursing. Influenced by a classics-rich curriculum, the Royal Shrewsbury School Hunt is the oldest running club in the world, with written records going back to 1831 and evidence that it was established by 1819. The school organized paper chase races in which runners followed a trail of paper shreds left by two foxes. Even today, RSSH runners are called hounds, and a race victory is a kill. The first definite record of Shrewsbury's cross-country annual steeplechase is in 1834, making it the oldest running race of the modern era. The school also lays claim to the oldest track and field meeting still in existence, originating in the second spring meeting first documented in 1840. This featured a series of throwing and jumping events with mock horse races, including the Derby Stakes, the Hurdle Race, and the Trial Stakes. Runners were entered by owners and named as though they were horses 13 miles 21. This national event was a great success, attracting a crowd of over 10,000 people in response. That same year, the Amateur Athletic Club was formed and held a championship for gentlemen amateurs in an attempt to reclaim the sport for the educated elite. Ultimately, the all-comers ethos of the NOAA won through, and the AAC was reconstituted as the Amateur Athletic Association in 1880, the first national body for the sport of athletics. The AAA Championships, the de facto British national championships despite being for England only, have been held annually since 3 July 1880, with breaks only during two world wars and 2006-2008. The AAA was effectively a global governing body in the early years of the sport, codifying its rules for the first time. Meanwhile, the United States began holding an annual national competition, the USA Outdoor Track and Field Championships, first held in 1876 by the New York Athletic Club. The establishment of general sports governing bodies for the United States, the Amateur Athletic Union in 1888, in France the Union des Sociétés Françaises de Sports Athlétiques in 1889, put the sport on a formal footing and meant that international competitions became possible. American athlete Jim Thorpe lost his Olympic medals for violating amateurism rules of the Olympic Games. The establishment of the modern Olympic Games at the end of the 19th century marked a new high for track and field. The Olympic athletics program, comprising track and field events plus a marathon race, contained many of the foremost sporting competitions of the 1896 Summer Olympics. The Olympics also consolidated the use of metric measurements in international track and field events, both for race distances and for measuring jumps and throws. The Olympic athletics program greatly expanded over the next decades, and track and field contests remained among the game's most prominent. The Olympics was the elite competition for track and field, and only amateur sportsmen could compete. Track and field continued to be a largely amateur sport, as this rule was strictly enforced. Jim Thorpe was stripped of his track and field medals from the 1912 Olympics after it was revealed that he had played baseball professionally that same year. The International Amateur Athletic Federation, IAAF, was established, becoming the international governing body for track and field, and it enshrined amateurism as one of its founding principles for the sport. The National Collegiate Athletic Association held their first men's outdoor track and field championship in 1921, making it one of the most prestigious competitions for students, and this was soon followed by the introduction of track and field at the inaugural World Student Games in 1923. The first continental track and field competition was the 1919 South American Championships, which was followed by the European Athletics Championships in 1934. Up until the early 1920s, track and field had been almost exclusively a male-only pursuit. Growing women's sports movement in Europe and North America led to the establishment of the Women's World Games in 1921, and this ultimately caused the introduction of five track and field events for women in the athletics at the 1928 Summer Olympics in China. Women's track and field events were being held in the 1920s, but were subject to criticism and disrespect from audiences in 1923. Physical education advocate Zhang Ruizhen called for greater equality and participation of women in Chinese track and field the rise of Kanue Hitomi and her 1928 Olympic medal for Japan signified the growth of women's track and field in East Asia. More women's events were gradually introduced as years progressed, although it was only towards the end of the century that the men's and women's programs approached parity of events, marking an increasingly inclusive approach to the sport. Major track and field competitions for disabled athletes were first introduced at the 1960 Summer Paralympics. Carl Lewis was among the athletes who helped increase track and field's profile with the rise of numerous regional championships, as well as the growth in Olympic-style multi-sport events such as the Commonwealth Games and the Pan American Games. Competitions between international track and field athletes became widespread from the 1960s onwards. The sport gained more exposure and commercial appeal through television coverage and the increasing wealth of nations after over half a century of amateurism. The amateur status of the sport began to be displaced by growing professionalism in the late 1970s. As a result, the Amateur Athletic Union was dissolved in the United States and it was replaced with a non-amateur body solely focused on the sport of athletics. The Athletics Congress, later USA Track and Field, the IAAF, soon followed suit in 1982, abandoning amateurism, and later removing all references to it from its name by rebranding itself as the International Association of Athletics Federations. The following year saw the establishment of the IAAF World Championships in Athletics, the first ever global competition just for athletics, which, with the Olympics, became one of track and field's most prestigious competitions. The profile of the sport reached a new high in the 1980s, with a number of athletes becoming household names such as Carl Lewis, Sergei Bubka, Sebastian Coe, Zola Budd and Florence Griffith Joyner. Many world records were broken in this period, and the added political element between competitors of the United States, East Germany, and the Soviet Union, in reaction to the Cold War, only served to stoke the sport's popularity. The increase in the commercial capacity of track and field was also met with developments in the application of sports science, and there were many changes to coaching methods, athletes' diet regimes, training facilities and sports equipment. This was also accompanied by an increase in the use of performance-enhancing drugs, and prominent cases, such as those of Olympic gold medalists Ben Johnson and Marion Jones, damaged the public image and marketability of the sport. From the 1990s onwards, track and field became increasingly more professional and international, as the IAAF gained over 200 member nations. The IAAF World Championships in Athletics became a fully professional competition with the introduction of prize money in 1997, and in 1998 the IAAF Golden League, an annual series of major track and field meetings in Europe, provided a higher level of economic incentive in the form of a $1 million jackpot in 2010. The series was replaced by the more lucrative IAAF Diamond League, a 14-meeting series held in Europe, Asia, North America and the Middle East. The first ever worldwide annual series of track and field meetings. Events. See also, list of athletics events. Track and field events are divided into three broad categories: track events, field events, and combined events. The majority of athletes tend to specialize in just one event or event type with the aim of perfecting their performances, although the aim of combined events athletes is to become proficient in a number of disciplines. Track events involve running on a track over a specified distances, and, in the case of the hurdling and steeplechase events, obstacles may be placed on the track. There are also relay races in which teams of athletes run and pass on a baton to their team member at the end of a certain distance. There are two types of field events: jumps and throws. In jumping competitions, athletes are judged on either the length or height of their jumps. The performances of jumping events for distance are measured from a board or marker, and any athlete overstepping this mark is judged to have fouled. In the jumps for height, an athlete must clear their body over a crossbar without knocking the bar off the supporting standards. The majority of jumping events are unaided, although athletes propel themselves vertically with purpose-built sticks in the pole vault. The throwing events involve hurling an implement such as a heavy weight, javelin or discus from a set point, with athletes being judged on the distance that the object is thrown. Combined events involve the same group of athletes contesting a number of different track and field events. Points are given for their performance in each event, and the athlete with the greatest points total at the end of all events is the winner. Official World Championship track and field events. Track field combined: relays, jumps, throws. 60 meters, 100 meters, 200 meters, 400 meters, 800 meters, 1500 meters, 3000 meters, 5000 meters, 10000 meters. 60 meters hurdles, 100 meters hurdles, 110 meters hurdles, 400 meters hurdles, 3000 meters steeplechase. 4 times 100 meters relay. 4 times 400 meters relay long jump triple jump high jump pole vault shot put discus throw hammer throw javelin throw pentathlon heptathlon decathlon note, events in italics are competed at indoor world championships only running sprints main article, sprint running the finish of a women's 100. 13 editions of the ancient Olympic Games featured only one event, the stadion race, which was a race from one end of the stadium to the other. Sprinting events are focused around athletes reaching and sustaining their quickest possible running speed. 3 sprinting events are currently held at the Olympics and outdoor world championships, the 100 meters, 200 meters, and 400 meters. These events have their roots in races of imperial measurements that later changed to metric, the 100. Off the blocks and a more comfortable stride to gain a slight competitive advantage. Citation needed. The 60 meters is a common indoor event and indoor world championship event. Less common events include the 50 meters, 55 meters, 300 meters and 500 meters, which are run in some high school and collegiate competitions in the United States. The 150 meters, though rarely competed, has a star-studded history. Pietro Mennea set a world best in 1983. Olympic champions Michael Johnson and Donovan Bailey went head-to-head over the distance in 1997, and Usain Bolt improved Mennea's record in 2009. Middle distance Arne Andersen left and Gunnar Hag right broke a number of middle distance world records in the 1940s. Further information, middle distance running. The most common middle distance track events are the 800 meters, 1,500 meters and mile run, although the 3,000 meters may also be classified as a middle distance event. The 880-yard run, or half mile, was the forebear of the 800. Runners start the race from a standing position along a curved starting line, and after hearing the starter's pistol they head towards the innermost track to follow the quickest route to the finish in 800. Top speed becomes less important, while qualities such as pace, race tactics and endurance become more so. Long distance Kenenisa Bekele leading in a long distance track event main article, long distance running. There are 3 common long distance running events in track and field competitions, 3,000 meters, 5,000 meters and 10,000 meters. The latter 2 races are both Olympic and World Championship events outdoors, while the 3,000. Qualified competitors want to win. The long-distance track events gained popularity in the 1920s by the achievements of the Flying Finns, such as multiple Olympic champion Paavo Nurmi. The successes of Emil Zatopek in the 1950s promoted intense interval training methods, but Ron Clark's world record-breaking feats established the importance of natural training and even-paced running. The 1990s saw the rise of North and East African runners in long-distance events. Kenyan and Ethiopian athletes, in particular, have since remained dominant in these events. Relay races main article. Relay race. Relay races are the only track and field event in which a team of runners directly compete against other teams. Typically, a team is made up of 4 runners of the same sex. Each runner completes their specified distance referred to as a leg before handing over a baton to a teammate, who then begins their leg. Upon receiving the baton, there is usually a designated area where athletes must exchange the baton. Teams may be disqualified if they fail to complete the change within the area, or if the baton is dropped during the race. A team may also be disqualified if its runners are deemed to have willfully impeded other competitors. Girls handing over the baton in a relay race in Leipzig in 1950. Relay races emerged in the United States in the 1880s as a variation on charity races between firemen, who would hand a red pennant onto teammates every 300. Carnivals are focused almost exclusively on relay events. Hurdling, a women's 400. For the 400, the women's steeplechase only gained world championship status in 2005, with its first Olympic appearance coming in 2008. Jumping long jump. Nade Gomes in the jumping phase of the event main article. Long jump. The long jump is one of the oldest track and field events, having its roots as one of the events within the ancient Greek pentathlon contest. The athletes would take a short run up and jump into an area of dug-up earth, with the winner being the one who jumped farthest. Small weights, halteres, were held in each hand during the jump, then swung back and dropped near the end to gain extra momentum and distance. The modern long jump, standardized in England and the United States around 1860, bears resemblance to the ancient event. Although no weights are used, athletes sprint along a length of track that leads to a jumping board and a sandpit. The athletes must jump before a marked line, and their achieved distance is measured from the nearest point of sand disturbed by the athlete's body. The athletics competition at the first Olympics featured a men's long jump competition, and a women's competition was introduced at the 1948 Summer Olympics. Professional long jumpers typically have strong acceleration and sprinting abilities. However, athletes must also have a consistent stride to allow them to take off near the board while still maintaining their maximum speed in addition to the traditional long jump. A standing long jump contest exists which requires that athletes leap from a static position without a run-up. A men's version of this event featured on the Olympic program from 1900 to 1912. Triple jump play media Olga Rypakova performing a triple jump in 2012. Main article, triple jump similar to the long jump. The triple jump takes place on a track heading towards a sandpit. Originally, athletes would hop on the same leg twice before jumping into the pit, but this was changed to the current hop, step and jump pattern from 1900 onwards. There is some dispute over whether the triple jump was contested in ancient Greece. While some historians claim that a contest of three jumps occurred at ancient games, others such as Stephen G. Miller believe this is incorrect, suggesting that the belief stems from a mythologized account of Phylas of Croton having jumped 55 ancient feet around 163. Not until 1993 that a women's version gained world championship status and went on to have its first Olympic appearance 3 years later. The men's standing triple jump event featured at the Olympics in 1900 and 1904, but such competitions have since become very uncommon, although it is still used as a non-competitive exercise drill. High jump. Main article, high jump. The first recorded instances of high jumping competitions were in Scotland in the 19th century. Further competitions were organised in 1840 in England, and in 1865 the basic rules of the modern event were standardized. There athletes have a short run-up and then take off from 1 foot to jump over a horizontal bar and fall back onto a cushioned landing area. The men's high jump was included in the 1896 Olympics and a women's competition followed in 1928. Jumping technique has played a significant part in the history of the event. High jumpers typically cleared the bar feet first in the late 19th century, using either the scissors, eastern cutoff or western roll technique. The straddle technique became prominent in the mid-20th century, but Dick Fosbury overturned tradition by pioneering a backwards and head-first technique in the late 1960s, the Fosbury flop, which won him the gold at the 1968 Olympics. This technique has become the overwhelming standard for the sport from the 1980s. Onwards, the standing high jump was contested at the Olympics from 1900 to 1912, but is now relatively uncommon outside of its use as an exercise drill. Pole vault. Anna Giordano Bruno releases the pole after clearing the bar. Main article, pole vault. In terms of sport, the use of poles for vaulting distances was recorded in Firlipin contests in the Frisian area of Europe, and vaulting for height was seen at gymnastics competitions in Germany in the 1770s. One of the earliest recorded pole vault competitions was in Cumbria, England in 1843. The basic rules and technique of the event originated in the United States. The rules required that athletes do not move their hands along the pole, and athletes began clearing the bar with their feet first and twisting so that the stomach faces the bar. Bamboo poles were introduced in the 20th century, and a metal box in the runway for planting the pole became standard. Landing mattresses were introduced in the mid-20th century to protect the athletes who were clearing increasingly greater heights. The modern event sees athletes run down a strip of track, plant the pole in the metal box, and vault over the horizontal bar before letting go of the pole and falling backwards onto the landing mattress, while earlier versions used wooden, metal or bamboo. Modern poles are generally made from artificial materials such as fiberglass or carbon fiber. The pole vault has been an Olympic event since 1896 for men, but it was over 100 years later that the first women's world championship competition was held at the 1997 IAAF World Indoor Championships. The first women's Olympic pole vaulting competition occurred in 2000. Throwing track and field contain some of the foremost kinds of throwing sports, and the four major disciplines are the only pure throwing events to feature at the Olympic Games. Shot put. Rimigius Matura preparing to throw within the circle. Main article, shot put. The genesis of the shot put can be traced to prehistoric competitions with rocks. In the Middle Ages, the stone put was known in Scotland, and the Steinstossen was recorded in Switzerland in the 17th century. Cannonball throwing competitions within the English military provided a precursor to the modern sport. The term shot originates from the use of round shot style ammunition for the sport. The modern rules were first laid out in 1860 and required that competitors take legal throws within a square throwing area of 7 feet 213. Dangerous and the side step and throw technique arising in the United States in 1876. The shot put has been an Olympic sport for men since 1896 and a women's competition using a 4 Women's discus was among the first women's events on the Olympic program, being introduced in 1928. Javelin throw. Bregi Krola beginning to throw the javelin. Main article: javelin throw as an implement of war and hunting. Javelin throwing began in prehistoric times along with the discus. The javelin was the second throwing event in the ancient Olympic pentathlon. Records from 708 BC show two javelin competition types coexisting: throwing at a target and throwing the javelin for distance. It was the latter type from which the modern event derives. In ancient competitions, athletes would wrap an ankle-thin leather strip around the javelin that acted as a sling to facilitate extra distance. The javelin throw gained much popularity in Scandinavia in the late 18th century, and athletes from the region are still among the most dominant throwers in men's competitions. The modern event features a short run-up on a track and then the thrower releases the javelin before the foul line. The first Olympic men's javelin throw contest was held in 1908, and a women's competition was introduced in 1932. The first javelins were made of various types of wood, but in the 1950s, former athlete Bud Held introduced a hollow javelin, then a metal javelin, both of which increased throwers' performances. Another former athlete, Miklos Németh, invented the rough-tailed javelin, and throws reached in excess of 100 measure between 1175. Scoring system, such as the decathlon scoring table. The ancient Olympic pentathlon comprising long jump, javelin, discus, the stadion race and wrestling was a precursor to the track and field combined events, and this ancient event was restored at the 1906 Summer Olympics. Intercalated games. A men's all-around was held at the 1904 Summer Olympics, contested between five American and two British athletes. Composition of combined events. Event track field. Men's decathlon 100 meters, 400 meters, 1500 meters, 110 meters hurdles, long jump, high jump, pole vault, shot put, discus throw, javelin throw. Women's heptathlon 200 meters, 800 meters, 100 meters hurdles, long jump, high jump, shot put, javelin throw. Men's heptathlon indoor 60 meters, 1000 meters, 60 meters hurdles, long jump, high jump, pole vault, shot put. Women's pentathlon indoor 800 meters, 60 meters hurdles, long jump, high jump, shot put. Stadium. The Panathinaikos Stadium was one of the first modern track and field stadiums outdoor. The term track and field is intertwined with the stadiums that first hosted such competitions. The two basic features of a track and field stadium are the outer oval-shaped running track and an area of turf within this track. The field in earlier competitions, track lengths varied. The Panathinaikos Stadium measured 33,333. 1960s 3M's tartan track. An all-weather running track of polyurethane gained popularity after its use at the 1968 U.S. Olympic Trials and the 1968 Summer Olympics, and it began the process in which synthetic tracks became the standard for the sport. Many track and field stadiums are multipurpose stadiums, with the running track surrounding a field built for other sports, such as the various types of football. A typical layout of an outdoor track and field stadium. The field of the stadium combines a number of elements for use in the jumping and throwing events. The long jump and triple jump areas comprise a straight, narrow 40-meter running track with a sandpit at one or both ends. Jumps are measured from a takeoff board, typically a small strip of wood with a plasticine marker attached, which ensures athletes jump from behind the measurement line. The pole vault area is also a 40-meter running track and has an indentation in the ground. The box where vaulters plant their poles to propel themselves over a crossbar before falling onto cushioned landing mats. The high jump is a stripped-down version of this, with an open area of track or field that leads to a crossbar with a square area of landing mats behind it. The four throwing events generally all begin on one side of the stadium. The javelin throw typically takes place on a piece of track that is central and parallel to the straights of the main running track. The javelin throwing area is a sector shape, frequently across the pitch. Sports field in the middle of the stadium, ensuring that the javelin has a minimal chance of causing damage or injury. The discus throw and hammer throw contests begin in a tall metal cage usually situated in one of the corners of the field. The cage reduces the danger of implements being thrown out of the field of play, and throws travel diagonally across the field in the center of the stadium. The shot put features a circular throwing area with a toe board at one end. The throwing area is a sector. Some stadia also have a water jump area on one side of the field. field specifically for steeplechase races indoor. The Aspire Dome during the 2010 World Indoor Championships. Basic indoor venues may be adapted gymnasiums, which can easily accommodate high jump competitions and short track events. Full-size indoor arenas, i.e. those fully equipped to host all events for the World Indoor Championships, bear similarities with their outdoor equivalents. Typically, a central area is surrounded by a 200-meter oval track with 4 to 8 lanes. The track can be banked at the turns to allow athletes to run around the radius more comfortably. Some have a second running track going straight across the field area, parallel to the straights of the main circuit. This track is used for the 60 meters and 60 meters hurdles events, which are held almost exclusively indoors. Another common adaptation is a 160-yard track 11 laps to a mile that fits into a common basketball court-sized arena. This was quite popular when races were held at imperial distances, which gradually was phased out by different organizations in the 1970s and 1980s. Examples of this configuration include the Milrose Games at Madison Square Garden, and the Sunkist Invitational formerly held in the Los Angeles Sports Arena. All four of the common jumping events are held at indoor venues. The long and triple jump areas run alongside the central 60. Regarding starting, running and finishing, starting men assuming the starting position for a sprint race. The start of a race is marked by a white line. 5 athletes may be called out of the blocks and the process started over. There are different types of starts for races of different distances. Middle and long distance races mainly use the waterfall start. This is when all athletes begin on a curved line that moves farther out at the outer edge of the track. Competitors are allowed to move towards the inside lane right away, as long as it is safe to do so. For some middle distance races, such as 800